Good morning, students. Welcome to my online class. My name is Flora, and today our subject is English Grammar. Chapter 22, Comprehension, page number 94 to 97. So today we are going to study about comprehensions. It is a very interesting topic and also very knowledgeable. It enhances our vocabulary and our thinking process. So let's begin. Reading comprehension needs logical power. A person needs to use his or her logic while solving the questions. But before that, he or she needs to read the comprehension or the paragraph properly. Without reading the paragraph or the comprehension, no one can solve the question answers properly. The question answers are given for revaluation so that one can know how much he or she has learnt from that comprehension. What is comprehension? The word comprehension means the ability to understand what you listen or what you read. So, what comprehension helps us for? It helps us to understand what we listen or what we read. It is an exercise which aims at improving or testing one's ability to understand a language. It helps us to understand the language, means the paragraph which is given. In a comprehension test, you are given a passage or a paragraph or two. These paragraphs shows the idea or mood, their solution that the author provides. As I have said earlier, one paragraph will be given to you and next to that some questions will be provided to you. Now, after reading the paragraph or the comprehension, what you have to do? With the help of that paragraph, you will solve the questions. Main task is to answer the question asked from the passage. Your main task is to solve the question, and those question answers are already there in the comprehension. What you need to do is you need to understand the comprehension properly, and then you have to see where the answers are given in between the comprehension. I'll repeat it again for you. The word comprehension means the ability to understand what you listen or what you read. It is an exercise which aims at improving or testing one's ability to understand a language. In a comprehension test, you are given a passage or a paragraph or two. These paragraphs shows the idea or mood, their solution that the author provides. Main task is to answer the question asked from the passage. Skills for understanding comprehension. Now we will study the skills that we need to understand comprehension or a paragraph. Number one, logical power. Number two, analytical ability. Number three, reasoning ability. Number four, ability to understand the main motive or idea of the author. Fifth, reading speed. And sixth, vocabulary power. I know these are very hard words for you, but I will make you understand one by one. Number one is logical power. Logical means it makes sense. That means comprehension, which is making a sense. And after reading the comprehension, what sense you are making by understanding it. It actually means that it makes sense. Next is analytical ability. It means that the comprehension giving us the information in smaller parts. You are getting or you are understanding very keenly, very minutely the paragraph. You are getting or you are understanding the smaller information which is being given by that paragraph. Second is reasoning. Reasoning ability is something that your mind actually thinks that why this question is being asked. Okay, where I will get the answer of this question in the paragraph. Next is ability to understand the main motive or the idea of the author. That means what the author want to say or what the author is giving the idea through that paragraph. Fifth, reading speed. It enhances our reading speed. Reading as many as comprehensions or paragraph make our reading skills and reading speed good. And last is vocabulary power. That means we get to know and we get to learn new words from the comprehension or the paragraphs. Now here is one example of comprehension. First, we will read the comprehension. Read the following passage carefully and answer briefly the questions given below. So what we will do? We will first read the paragraph or the passage. Reading is a good habit. We should read excellent books, magazines, and newspapers. We should study our school books carefully. We should go to the school library to read books on various subjects. A library is a building which has a large collection of books on many subjects. We should read books on English language and literature, science, history, geography, etc. A careful study of magazines and newspapers increases our knowledge about the world. Magazines and newspapers are the best source of knowledge, information and entertainment. Reading makes us intelligent. It increases our knowledge about language and words. So this was the passage. Now we will go to the questions. What is a good habit? Now what we have to do, we have to find the answer. That what is a good habit? See the first line. There is written, reading is a good habit. So we have got our answer that what is a good habit? Reading is a good habit. Next question. What should we read? See the next line. We should read good books, magazines and newspapers. We have got our next answer also. In the next line itself, we should read good books, or you can write excellent books, magazines and newspapers. Next is, why should we go to the school library? See the next line in the passage. We should study our school books carefully. We should go to the school library to read books on various subjects. So we have got our third answer also in the fourth line of the passage. Like this only you have to search the answers, and for that you need to read the passage carefully. Fourth is, which building has a large collection of books on many subjects? The answer is, a library has a large collection of books on all subjects. Next question, books of which subject should be read by us? Yes, we should read books on English, science, history, etc. Next, what are the best source of knowledge, information and entertainment? Magazine and newspaper are the best source of knowledge and information. What makes us intelligent? Reading makes us intelligent. The second last line of the passage. Like this only you will get your all answers in the comprehension only, which will be given to you in your exams. Okay. Now we will go to the next passage. Exercise. Now we will start with our exercise or worksheet. Read each of the passages carefully and answer the question given below it. First of all, we will read the passage and then we will solve the question. Number one, morning walk is good for health. Morning is the most pleasant time of the day. Nature is at best at this time. We should go for a morning walk regularly. Parks, gardens and other places with greenery are the best place for a morning walk. We get fresh, cool and clean air in the morning. Fresh air refreshes our body A person who goes for a morning walk every day remains happy and active throughout the day. Morning walk gives energy to the people and keeps them away from diseases. It is an excellent exercise. So this passage is all about what? Morning walk. So we know that the answers must be based on what? Morning walk. So let's now see the question answers. Questions of first comprehension. Question 1. What is good for health? Morning walk is good for health. What is the most pleasant time of the day? Morning time is the most pleasant time of the day. What are the best places for morning walk? Parks, gardens, and other places with greenery are the best places for a morning walk. Which type of air do we get in the morning? We get fresh, cool, and clean air in the morning. Who remains happy and active throughout the day? A person who goes for a morning walk every day remains happy and active throughout the day. What gives energy to people and keeps them away from disease? Morning walk gives energy to the people and keeps them away from the diseases. I'll repeat it again for you. What is good for health? Morning walk is good for health. What is the most pleasant time of the day? Morning time is the most pleasant time of the day. What are the best place for a morning walk? Parks, gardens, and other places with greenery are the best places for morning walk. What type of air do we get in the morning? Which type of air do we get in the morning? We get fresh, cool, and clean air in the morning. Who remain happy and active throughout the day? A person who goes for a morning walk every day remains happy and active throughout the day. What gives energy to the people and keeps them away from diseases? Morning walk gives energy to the people and keeps them away from diseases. Second passage. Jawaharlal Nehru was the first Prime Minister of India. He was a freedom fighter and a very popular national leader. He was born on November 14, 1889 at Allahabad. His father's name was Motilal Nehru. Jawaharlal Nehru received his education at Harrow School and Trinity College, Cambridge. He became the President of Indian National Congress. His only dream was to achieve complete freedom for the country. Our country became independent on August 15, 1947. Jawaharlal Nehru worked hard throughout his life for the development of the country. He loved children very much. Children called him Chacha Nehru. This great leader of India died on May 27, 1964. So, from the passage itself, what we are understanding that the questions will be based on whom? Chacha Jawaharlal Nehru. So, now we'll study the question answers. Questions of second comprehension. Question 1. Who was the first Prime Minister of India? Jawaharlal Nehru was the first Prime Minister of India. When and where was Jawaharlal Nehru born? November 14, 1889 at Allahabad, Jawaharlal Nehru was born. What was the name of Jawaharlal Nehru's father? The name of Jawaharlal Nehru's father was Motilal Nehru. Where did Jawaharlal Nehru received his education? Harrow School and Trinity College, Cambridge. When did India become independent? India became independent on August 15, 1947. When did Jawaharlal Nehru die? Jawaharlal Nehru died on May 27, 1964. I'll repeat it again for you. Who was the first Prime Minister of India? Jawaharlal Nehru was the first Prime Minister of India. When and where was Jawaharlal Nehru born? November 14, 1889 at Allahabad. What was the name of Jawaharlal Nehru's father? The name of Jawaharlal Nehru's father was Motilal Nehru. Where did the Jawaharlal Nehru receive his education? Harrow School and Trinity College, Cambridge. When did India become independent? India became independent on August 15, 1947. When did Jawaharlal Nehru die? Jawaharlal Nehru died on May 27, 1964. Third passage. The sun is the source of light and energy for us. It is actually a star. It has 8 planets: Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. These planets revolve around it. The sun is very large in size. It looks small because it is very far away from us. It is the sun which makes life possible on earth. The sun rises in the east and sets in the west. People get up early in the morning with the sunrise. It is the time of the day when light first appears. So what we get to know that this passage is all about sun. Now we will see the question answers. Questions of third comprehension. What is the source of light and energy for us? The sun is the source of light and energy for us. How many planets does the sun have? Write their names. It has 8 planets. Number 1, Mercury. Then Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Why does the sun look small to us? It looks small because it is very far away from us. What makes life possible on the earth? The sun makes life possible on the earth. Which direction does the sun rise and set in? The sun rises in the east and sets in the west. Write a suitable title for the above passage. A suitable title for the above passage, the sun. I'll repeat it again for you. What is the source of light and energy for us? The sun is the source of light and energy for us. How many planets does the sun have? Write their names. It has 8 planets: Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Why does the sun look small to us? It looks small because it is very far away from us. What makes life possible on the earth? The sun makes life possible on the earth. Which direction does the sun rise and set in? Sun rises in the east and sets in the west. Write a suitable title for the above passage. A suitable title for the above passage, the sun. Now, next part of the third passage is write the antonyms of the following words. Antonym means opposite. So, the first word is large. Large opposite is small. Far, near. Possible, impossible. Sunrise, sunset. Early, late. Again, I will repeat it for you. Large, small. Far, near. Possible, impossible. Sunrise, sunset. Early, late. With this, we complete all our exercises. Number 1, 2, and 3. Now, what? 3. Third passage has 2 questions, question answers and the antonym of the following words. Now what you have to do, students, write all the question answers in your copies. No need to write the passage in your copies, only write the question answers. Those who don't have books, but those who have books can write these passages, question answers in your book itself. Space is given in your book. You can write the answers in your book only. But those who don't have book can write all the question answers in your copy, but no need to write the passage. Complete your work properly with the correct spelling and a nice handwriting. Next is just for fun. Now students, I have given one activity for you. This activity you will not write in your copies or not in your books. It's just for fun. What you have to do when you will watch this video, when you'll get this slide, just pause the video and see what is written and I will read it for you. Now try to answer the questions by yourself and write it down in your copies, in a rough copy. So I will read the passage. This is John. He is 8 years old. He's tall and fat. He's got blonde hair and big brown eyes. He can ride a bike and swim. He can't skip and he can't dance. His favorite toy is a boat. It's red. He's got 3 blue yo-yos and a yellow yo-yo too. Now the question, what's his name? How old is he? Has he got blue eyes? Is he fat? Is he short? Can he swim? Has he got red hair? Is his boat blue? Has he got 3 yo-yos? Can he ride a bike? Now what you have to do? Just try to answer these questions while you see the video also, and you can write the answers in your rough copy also. No need to write the answers in your grammar copy. So students, I think you all have understood this topic comprehension. Write all the question answers in your copies. No need to write the passage in your copy. And those who have got book can write the answers in the book itself. Try to complete all the work timely, properly and with a neat handwriting. We'll meet again. Till then, be safe. Thank you.